Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. Just few days back, there was a news about new LLM model released by Meta, which is Facebook's parent company, which is once again breaking lot of benchmarks, and it's already better than one of the best AI LLM model, that is Cloud 3. If you have not been living under the rock, there is almost a daily barrage of latest innovations that are happening in the space of AI. If you think about the timelines of the human history, we are living in an unprecedented time. If the late 19th century was about the invention of electric power, telecommunication, and automotive technologies, then 1920s and 30s was all about radio, aviation, and early computing. And then came 40s to 60s, which is World War and post-World War era, where microelectronics revolution happened and subsequent rise of computers and space technology happened, where humans reached moon. 70s and 90s was the era of personal computers, internet, and mobile technology. 1920s has been about artificial intelligence. It's all about AI, generative AI, machine learning, LLMs, and ChatGPTs. And we may not realize it, we are living in an unprecedented timeline where we are part of the history where this revolution is taking place in front of our eyes. But for the uninitiated who is new to this field, probably you will get started with the very basic question as to what is AI. As you try to understand this field, you are going to get bombarded with a lot of other questions like what is machine learning, what is deep learning, what is generative AI, what breakthrough led to the LLMs, that is large language models, and what is LLM, what is ChatGPT, how does AI landscape actually looks like? Where does LLM fit in the whole AI landscape? And how did we even end up here with the LLMs? And are there any limitations to the LLMs? Or for that matter, AI? And last but not the least, where are we headed? And then probably most of us are thinking, are we in an AI bubble similar to a dot-com bubble that happened few decades back? Well, these are all very legitimate questions. So let's just start with something very basic. Where does the LLM fit into the whole AI landscape? And what does the AI landscape actually looks like? If you want to get started with very basic programming in AI, you need to have an understanding of how this landscape looks like. It is just similar to like constructing a house. If you are constructing a house, you should know where you have bought the plot, where are the roads leading to, where it basically joins the highway, where is the nearest school, where is the nearest hotel, where is the nearest hospital, where is the nearest corporation office, where is the nearest police station. So until and unless you don't understand the landscape in which you are operating in, it is very difficult to understand what you can do in the landscape that you are operating in. So let's get started with probably the most common term that you might have heard in the recent times, which is ChatGPT or Cloud 3 or Llama, which basically all fall into a category of large language models or GPTs. This large language model or GPTs basically come under a kind of models called as transformer models. And this transformer model come under a category of AI called as deep learning. And this deep learning is a sub-branch of weak AI, or also called as narrow AI. And that is one of the branch of AI. If this is how the chain of the evolution of large language model looks like, what are the missing pieces here? And where does this fit into the whole AI landscape? So in this video and next couple of videos, it is all about artificial intelligence orientation. I would like to take you through a journey of trying to understand the overall AI landscape that has evolved so far. Well, this is just one chain of technologies. The whole AI field is quite big. We will try to understand all of these things over next couple of videos. If you pay attention, all of these five basic AI fields diverge from one concept called as narrow AI, or also called as weak AI. Now, the question is, what does this weak AI mean, or why is it even called as narrow AI? Well, the reason why this is called as narrow AI or a weak AI is it is designed and trained for very specific tasks. It operates under a very limited predefined range of set of context. Most AI systems that we use today are narrow AI, including the ChatGPT. Think about anything that you are seeing about AI, image recognition, voice assistants like Siri, Alexa, language translation services. Everything and anything that you are seeing right now or have used or using is basically part of this particular narrow AI field. The other one is general AI, or also called as strong AI. Right now, this is just a concept. This thing doesn't exist as of now. Theoretically, it exists. Lot of research is going on. When I say strong AI or a general AI, it basically refers to a AI system with human cognitive abilities. It has consciousness. If it is presented with an unfamiliar task, this AI should be able to figure it out without human intervention. It should understand, learn, apply the knowledge in different contexts. For example, if I just tell go and clean a house, it need not be trained about what kind of house. Is it an apartment? Is it a bungalow? Or is it a hut? Just by going there, depending upon the kind of house, it needs to figure out how do I clean it? Where can I find the tools to clean it? Is it even cleanable? So a human would be able to do it. A general AI or a strong AI should be able to do it as a concept. Right now, we have not reached that stage. So anything that we are using right now does not come under general AI or a strong AI. Then comes super intelligent AI. What is super intelligent AI? It is basically a hypothetical stage of AI where the capability would significantly surpass that of the brightest and most gifted human minds in practically every field, including scientific creativity, general wisdom, and social skills. Think of it like Terminator movie, basically. And once again, this is a very hypothetical concept as of now. People discuss about it, philosophers discuss about it, but we have not yet reached at that stage where we can say that we have a capability to see a super intelligent AI in next couple of years. Forget about super intelligent AI. We have not yet even reached general AI or strong AI. And even the narrow AI is capable of doing only few things. Under narrow AI, there is classical AI, machine learning, deep learning, generative models, and hybrid models. So let's discuss about classical AI. This thing is also called as symbolic AI. In this so-called classical AI or symbolic AI, the artificial intelligence was still very rule-based and was based on the logic and knowledge engineering. What do you mean by knowledge engineering? Basically, getting all the knowledge and using that to engineer a solution. So it involved deductive logical reasoning, creating an extensive hard-coded domain knowledge. To put it in a nutshell, you still wrote code in classical AI. Of course, the complexity of the code was very, very advanced, but there was no concept of learning as such. People with very deep understanding of the domain wrote very complicated logic to make it look like they were artificial intelligence. Some of the things that came out of this classical AI were decision trees, support vector machines, and logic-based AI. And under decision tree, there was random forest. And logic-based AI gave rise to expert systems and rule-based systems. We won't be going through these things in a very detailed manner because that's not the intention. So let's continue. So of course, there was a success that was seen during this era. There was a system which could play a checkers game. And then there was a logic theorist application which was mimicking human mathematical theorem proofs. It was basically able to prove certain mathematical theorems as if humans were giving proof to those particular theorems. And if you are wondering which timeline is this, it is basically around 1950s to 1980s. So AI as a formal academic discipline was born in 1956 during Dartmouth conference, organized by a couple of guys, but main founders were basically John McCarthy, Marvin Minsky, and a couple of other guys. This gathering aimed to explore the possibility of machines simulating every aspect of human intelligence. The term artificial intelligence was basically coined here in 1956 during the Dartmouth conference. And you can basically think that the timeline between the 1950s to 60s was basically an era of classical AI. But throughout the era of 1950s and 80s, even though there were a lot of successes with these systems, there were limitations. The first limitation was basically the computational power limitation. We didn't have very powerful machines. It was too early. And then we did not have a proper understanding of the human intelligence. To give you an example, the human neuron was discovered around 1906. And we still did not understand how human neuron actually works. Even now also we don't completely understand. So it was too early to apply a theoretical understanding of human intelligence to create an artificial intelligence. And also there was lack of robust theoretical frameworks. Statistics was still in very early stages, at least not in a stage where it can be applied in the field of AI. The ones that we see recently in all our AI advancements nowadays. And then it was also lack of funding in AI research. So it was around at that time in 1980s where certain breakthroughs were made and a new era emerged. And that era was machine learning. In the next video, we will try to understand how this machine learning is different from classical AI and what happened with machine learning inception. So stay tuned. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.